Welcome to the Business Blast Podcast. I'm your host, Tyler Wagner. This episode is brought to you by Authors Unite. Authors Unite provides you with all the resources you need to become a successful author. You can learn more about Authors Unite and join the free community at authorsunite.com. Now, let's jump into the episode. All right, everyone, welcome back to another episode of the Business Blast Podcast. I'm your host, Tyler Wagner. Today I have Jeff Selig with us. He works in recruiting full-time and is a network marketer on the side. So welcome to the show, Jeff.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Of course. Pumped to have you on, man. We'll dive into the first one. The first question I have for you, Jeff, is what is the best story from your life that has an underlying valuable message?
Right. That's an excellent question. You know, one I would probably point to is there's actually two stories that go together. They relate to the same topic, but it was going back to high school. I ended up getting into a relationship that a mentor of mine told me not to get into. And it was a relationship with another girl, sweet girl, but just wasn't really lined up with my life purpose and where I wanted to go. Now, I had a bit of an ego problem, and it's amazing how ego can get in the way. But what ended up happening was I spent about a year and a half of my life dating this girl, and it just was not, I knew in my heart it wasn't supposed to be the right thing, and the mentor was right. So never let ego get in the way. And that also happened 2 or 3 years later. I did not learn my lesson. So it took me 2 experiences of the same type of situation where a mentor told me what was right. I didn't listen to logic. I listened to emotion, and it hurt me in the end. So always listen to your mentors.
Yes, man. I've been there, brother. I know what you're talking about. the next one I got for you is, what is the most valuable piece of information we should know that's within your expertise or industry?
Yes, I would point to, I deal with a lot of people every day, and that's whether on the phone or face-to-face, building relationships with somebody I really have no background with. And I would say that trust is essential to any business success, because without trust, there can be no relationship. And that's really the best way to establish and maintain good business relationship that'll lead to more money in your pocket.
And what is your best piece of overall business advice? So not necessarily industry specific.
My best piece of overall business advice would be to, I would say that you need to have a definiteness of purpose and complete focus with everything that you do. Don't stretch yourself too thin. Have a goal in mind and make a series of decisions that lead you to your end goal.
And if you could give your younger self one piece of advice, what would that be?
That piece of advice would be to drop the ego. Listen to those in life who have what you want, even if it doesn't make sense. Take their advice, run with it. You'll learn later. It will benefit you in the long run.
And in your opinion, what is the key to happiness?
The key to happiness is really, I would say, doing what you want every day for the rest of your life. And it's really how I would define success. Success and happiness in my mind they coincide, but happiness is a choice. It's a decision that you're going to have positive emotions and thoughts. So I guess a choice to do what you want for the rest of your life.
And what is the best book that you've read, and what was the number one thing you learned from that?
Undoubtedly, Think and Grow Rich was the best book I've ever read. It's the first book that my mentor gave to me. And through that book, I learned that the one thing that we as human beings have complete control over is our thoughts. And thoughts are so very important to living a good life. And that book was revelatory for me in realizing that I can control my thoughts, therefore I can control my life.
And what is your favorite quote and why?
My favorite quote is really, I'm going to share one with you that I heard recently by Malcolm X, and that is, if you tolerate something in your life, and I'm actually just going off the top of my head here, but if you tolerate something in your life that you don't appreciate, but you don't hate it, that thing will eventually remain in your life. So if there's something you want to get rid of in your life that is something you tolerate, it will eventually own you, and you won't be able to overcome that thing. Mm.
Thank you, man, for coming on. We really appreciate it. The last question that I do have for you before we let you go is, where is the best place for people to find you online?
Absolutely. LinkedIn and Facebook are two places that I'm all over. Don't really go on Instagram, so I'd probably say Facebook and LinkedIn.
Perfect, brother. Thanks again for joining us.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.
The podcast you just heard was published with Anchor. Got something you want to say to the creator of this show? Send them a voice message using the Anchor app, free for iOS and Android.